This is the dissected specimen of left upper limb. This is the lateral side and this is the medial side of this limb. So ulna nerve, it's formed in the axilla as continuation of medial cord of brachial plexus and it conveys fibers from C8 and T1. This is the brachial artery. In the proximal half of the arm, the nerve accompanies along the medial side of brachial artery. This is the ulna nerve. And near the middle of the arm, the nerve pierces the medial intermuscular septum and enters the posterior compartment of the arm. And it descends between the medial intermuscular septum and the triceps muscle. Here, this is the medial epicondyle. Here it lodges in a groove on the dorsal surface of base of medial epicondyle. Now, the nerve leaves the arm and enters the forearm. It gives no branches in the arm. It enters the forearm by passing between the humeral and ulnar head of flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. So this is the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle and this is the ulna nerve. In the upper third of the forearm, the nerve is more deeply placed, overlapped by the flexor carpi ulnaris. And the lower two-third, the nerve become more superficial, lying lateral to the tendon of the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Here it is accompanied by the ulnar artery on its radial side. This is the lateral side. On the lateral side, it is accompanied by the ulnar artery. And it enters the palm by passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. This is the hypothenar eminence. On reaching the proximal part of the hypothenar eminence, the ulna nerve divides into superficial and deep terminal branches. This is a superficial branch and this is a deep terminal branch. Ulna nerve gives muscular branches in the forearm. It supplies the flexor carpi ulnaris and also the medial part of the flexor digitorum profundus muscle. In the hand, the ulna nerve divides into superficial and deep terminal branch. The superficial branch supplies the palmaris brevis muscle and divides into medial and lateral palmar digital nerves for cutaneous distribution for medial 1.5 fingers. And this is the deep terminal branch. This is the abductor digitae minimae muscle and this is the flexor digitae minimae. This passes between the abductor and flexor digitae minimae. And here beneath the flexor digitae minimae, we can see the opponent's digitae minimae. Here the nerve pierces the opponent's digitae minimae and passes beneath the long flexor tendons. I'm lifting the long flexor tendons. And here you can see the deep branch of ulna nerve. And here it occupies the concavity of the deep palmar arch. You can see the deep palmar arch here, deep palmar arch. And here the deep branch of ulna nerve occupies the concavity of the deep palmar arch. And this finally supplies the three hypothenar muscles, third and fourth lumbricals, four dorsal introci, four palmar introci, and the adductor pollicis muscle.